I'm Dylan Eberhard.
I'm Cole Casey.
And I'm Jacob Malkin. And for our feedback project, we decided to look at controlling shipyard gantry cranes. And Dylan's going to talk a little more about what that means.
Yeah, so here's our problem setting. In the world, especially in the 21st century, trading globally has become extremely important to get items from country to country. And a huge part of that has been loading cargo containers onto and off of ships. So we thought that was pretty cool, so we decided to do shipping yard gantry cranes. And our goal here was to make sure that they are quick and accurate, and so that can increase the efficiency of the gantry cranes in the shipping yards, which is always a huge part of business, is the efficiency. So our design focuses on a gantry crane with a rope that is 10 meters in length. This made the math easier on us. And what we wanted to do was we wanted to be able to ensure that it moves quickly, that it is accurate in the position that we put in when it stops, and we want to minimize the swing once it gets to its destination. And these can be achieved by tuning the steady state error, the settling time, and the percent overshoot.
Cool, so for our model, this was our transfer function, 1 over quantity L over G S cubed plus S. So this transfer function was arrived at from a physical model of our system. So here is our gantry trolley. Our input to the system is the gantry velocity. So this was very important, has some implications in future parts of our analysis. So it's very important to note that it is the velocity of the trolley. The output is the load position. So it's measured in the same direction as the gantry velocity, but you can see it's dangling below the gantry, and from this physical model, we were able to arrive at this transfer function. And this was the step response applied to this transfer function. So essentially, conceptually, we're taking the velocity of the trolley from 0 meters per second to 1 meter per second. That would be a step input. And what we see makes sense. So we'd expect that if you suddenly made the velocity of the trolley 1 meter per second, the trolley would just start to translate, the load might lag a little bit, and you'd see some oscillation in the load. But you'd see that the load is continually moving to the right. So unbounded motion. And that's what we see. We see that the system is unstable, and from our step response, we can see that the position of our load is moving off to infinity.
So for our analysis, we have poles at 0 and plus or minus I, as you can see here in our root locus. According to our calculations, using our MATLAB root locus plot, we will always have points that will lie on or to the right of the imaginary axis due to the poles. Because of this, our system will be bivalve unstable. Our steady state error will also be 0 as the crane returns to the correct position after the oscillations, as Jake described earlier. Our rope will take about 10 seconds, I guess the crane will take about 10 seconds to finish oscillating. So it's a little slower than we would like, but we can get it to be much quicker than that without sacrificing other elements. Also, our step response goes to infinity, which causes instability due to our oscillations.
Yeah, so in our initial design, we first decided that we need to pick our constraints on it. And we went with our settling time to be less than 12 seconds. And this is important because once the crane reaches its position, you don't want that swing for too long because you need to be efficient and drop that load pretty quickly. So that's the reason for that. We wanted our overshoot to be less than 1% because if your load is swinging way out past, like just straight down, one, you can damage the goods, but it also is going to make your settling time a lot longer, which is a problem. And then we wanted our steady state error to be 0 because you want your position to be accurate where you get to where you tell it to go, because if you're off by even something like 3-2 inches when you drop it, that could be detrimental when your ship is out at sea and, you know, it shifts and falls off the ship. So the next part of the design was kind of preliminary picking a controller that we need to do. And we decided to go with a PD controller with an extra derivative. And the reasoning behind this is our transfer function was unstable as shown before. And when we did the Ralph Horowitz on that, we realized the reason for this is because there's an SQ term here there's no s squared term, there's an s term, and there's a constant that's missing. So the s squared and that constant being missing is what's causing the instability. So we were trying to figure out a way to get those back in there. And the way we saw to do that was with a PD controller with the extra derivative. And when we did the analysis of that closed loop system and did the two feedback loops on it, we wound up with an s cubed in the denominator with an s squared, an s, and that constant. So that caused it to be more, or to be stable, just in general, which is what we were looking for. And by just kind of guessing and checking on it, we found preliminarily that KP should be about 8 and KD should be 16, and that got us close to where we wanted on our constraints and also gave us stability.
Cool, so for verification and iteration, like Dylan said, we first tried KP is 8 and KD is 16, but we weren't quite hitting that settling time that we wanted to. So we just started cranking K up. And what we found was that we could crank K very high, hit all of our constraints. We could hit the settling time constraint, our percent overshoot would be under 1%, and we would have zero steady state error. But our rise times were very small, and our rise time being very small has some implications for the crane. So if the crane is moving from 0 to 1 meter in, you know, a tenth of a second, then our velocity on the crane is unreasonable. Our crane would be moving too quickly, much faster than any crane in real life could. So we were forced to dial back the crane gain, and what we found was that a gain of about 1.8 was optimal. It gave us our settling time that we were looking for. This shows a settling time of about 14 seconds, so pretty close to that settling time we were looking for. We have zero steady state error, so our load is landing right over top of where we expect it to. The only thing is that we do not hit our percent overshoot constraint. And unless we were to look at more advanced controllers or something like that, it may not be possible for us to hit this overshoot constraint while also being considerate of the rise time. So with our K at about 1.8, our rise time was about 0.6 seconds, which means our crane is moving at about 2 meters per second, or about 6 feet per second, which is a very reasonable speed for a gantry crane to be moving with a heavy load.
So here for robustness, we can see a gain margin that we calculated to be negative 359 decibels. This number is very close in magnitude to zero. Because we have a unique transfer function, our Bode plots are not ideal. MATLAB says that our gain margin, as we said, is negative 359 decibels. However, the phase, as we can see in our this plot down here, our phase will never cross 180. So to us, it seems like you can kind of just turn up the gain margin to as high as you want, as you would like. As we said earlier, you can set K very high to meet our specifications. However, the velocity was too high to have a realistic application. And our moving on, our phase margin is 57. 0.3 degrees, and our time delay is 0.422 seconds. This is also our max time delay. This time delay really isn't an issue because the controller is right on the gantry crane. This should allow for more flexibility for the operator in regards to response time. With a delay of only 0.422 seconds, the user will be able to complete the tasks in the correct time. If you were to do this again, we would try to have more realistic constraints, and also doing this, use a more complicated controller, which we don't necessarily learn about in this class. Thank you for watching, and these are works cited. And thank you for watching our presentation on gantry cranes for the EENG 307 feedback controls final project.